Well, it's starting to get pretty darn cold outside, and I was hoping to take the trailer out one more time, but it just looks like that's not going to be a possibility this season. Now, where I live, it gets very cold in the winter, down below 10 degrees, sometimes closer to zero. But I'm going to show you today how I winterize the water system without putting antifreeze into the potable water system. There are just a few items that you'll need to do this yourself. I like to sanitize my water system before I winterize it. So you're going to need a little bleach and a container with a spout. In order to blow out the lines, you'll need an air compressor. And if you have one of these soft tips, I highly recommend those. And then also, we're going to need a few gallons of RV marine antifreeze. Now, I mentioned earlier that I will not be putting these into the potable water system, but rather these will be for the gray and black holding tanks, as well as the P-traps on the sink and the toilet. First, fill your container about halfway full with water and then add bleach. You'll want to add 1/4 cup for every 15 gallons in your holding tanks. My holding tank's about 40 gallons, so I'm going to add about 3/4 cup, and then I'm going to dump it right into the tank. Once you've added the bleach, go ahead and fill the tank the rest of the way using fresh water. And please note that this water is not safe to drink. Be sure to stick around to the end. I'll show you one important tip that a lot of people forget to do. Next, turn on your water pump and turn on each faucet, both hot and cold, and run at least 1 gallon through each fixture. Don't forget about your outdoor shower fixture, and be sure to flush your toilet a few times. Now, if you're doing this right, you should smell a little bit of bleach. Now that the tank and water lines are full of that bleach water, we want to let that water sit in the lines for a few hours before we do anything else. After a few hours, go ahead and empty all the water into your sinks and toilet, and then whatever's left, open up the tank drain and then the low point drains on your trailer. We want to get all of that bleach water out of the system. Once the tank is completely empty, go ahead and close the drain valve and refill the tank with fresh water. We're not going to use any bleach this time. With the tank full, go ahead and flush both hot and cold in each fixture until you no longer smell bleach. Now at this point, your two holding tanks should be pretty full, so go ahead and dump them. After draining the tanks, I add about 2 gallons of fresh water to the toilet and about 3/4 gallon of antifreeze, leaving just a little bit to cover the valve. I add about 2 gallons of water to the gray tank as well, and the last 1.25 gallon will go into each of the drains, including the bathtub drain. Before you drive home, open all the valves on all the faucets, then open the drain valves on your potable water tank and your low point drains. Next, I close all the valves in the trailer and leave these 2 low point drains open. I put a little air into the hot line, about 20 psi, and blow the water out of the cold line. After water stops coming out of the cold valve, I close it, then I go into the trailer and open 1 valve in the trailer and repeat the process. After blowing out each individual valve inside the trailer, the next thing to do is the toilet. This one's a little bit tricky, where we have the cold valve closed, we pressurize the hot line, and while it's still under pressure, we close it. Very gently press on the toilet valve to release the pressure. Repeat each of these steps with each valve until no more water is coming out of the system. Once you're done blowing out the system, go ahead and open all the valves again, and we'll move on to that last step I mentioned earlier. Now, the last thing you're going to want to do is to remove this strainer off the pump, which will be full of water, and as you can see on mine, it's kind of got some green goo growing inside. And that's actually pretty typical for the end of the season. Most people don't know that they need to take this strainer out, see how cruddy that is, and clean it out. Now I'm going to leave this strainer cap open throughout the winter. I'm just going to cover it up with these paper towels. That way a little air can get into the system and hopefully all the residual water can evaporate out in the next few weeks. Now you may be asking yourself right now, did I really save any time by not just pumping that pink antifreeze through the potable water system? And the answer probably is no, I probably didn't save that much time. But to be quite honest, I don't like that pink stuff in my drinking water lines. Even after flushing a few times in the spring, I can still taste it. And I know a trace amount's not gonna kill you, but I still don't like it in there. So I'm gonna continue to use air to blow out my lines when I winterize. Well, I hope you found this video interesting. I plan on making more videos, maybe one this fall, maybe more in the spring. So look forward to those, and happy camping!